Hello bookish friends, welcome to my September wrap up part 1. In this video I will talk about the 6 works that I finished in the first half of September. Like I did in the previous videos, I will insert the clips that I've recorded very soon after I finish those works. Today is the 3rd of September and I finished the first book that I was reading in the month, which was a book that I did not mention in my TBR because I decided to join the Nancy Drew read-along hosted by Mitzi at Reads and Writes at the end of August. And there's a Voxer group in which we chat about Nancy Drew and our love for nostalgia, mystery books, teenage detectives. It's still not the end of the month, so if you want to join this group, please message Mitzi and she will include you in our Voxer group. The first book in the Nancy Drew series was written in 1930, which is The Secret of the Old Clock by Carolyn Keene. Carolyn Keene is a pseudonym for many writers, both female and male. In my application, I found the 1930 edition and I read that story, which was a bit different than the revised edition that I've read when I was a teenager. But fundamentally, the plot is the same. In this book, we follow Nancy Drew, who is a daughter of a quite famous lawyer. And she tries to find the missing will of an old man, which would give his inheritance to the rightful and very kind poor relatives and friends. Because I read the 1930 edition, I looked up the revisions. And I saw that the revisions were done quite justly, I think, because there were some parts which dragged on and on. And in the revised edition, they were condensed. More importantly, there were some really racial issues, which seems very, very, very outdated. Lastly, Nancy is a bit aggressive in this old edition. But overall, I really found the writing style very, very engaging. So many good memories came back to me, like when I was a teenager. I read the book in only 2 days. Even though I tried, I couldn't stop reading. If I had read the revised edition, I would have given this book an 8 out of 10. But because I read the 1930 edition, which has some faults, I gave The Secret of the Old Clock by Carolyn Keene a 7 out of 10. Today is the 5th of September and I finished the book that I was reading for my real life mini book club. In this book club, with my three best friends, I read a book and discuss it online. We decided to choose a book that would be engaging. We chose a book from Jean-Christophe Grange. Two of us had read him before and really found his books quite engaging. The book we chose was called Leylekli'nin Uçuşu, The Flight of the Storks. In this book, we follow Louis, who is a French orphan raised by his godparents. One day, he makes a deal with a man who's very, very interested in the migration route of the storks. The man would give him quite a lot of money for him to observe the anomaly that is happening in the flight of the storks. Before his mission starts, this old man is murdered. Louis, because of curiosity and also because he really wanted to deserve the money, so he goes on the predetermined mission. And in this mission, extending to many, many, many countries, Bulgaria, Slovakia, Israel, the Central Republic of Africa, France, and India. And during this very multinational journey, he encounters a link between corpses whose hearts have been taken out and an organization who smuggles diamonds out of Africa. This book was actually a great disappointment for me. It actually started quite fine. The story was very, very interesting at first, and I was intrigued to find out about the mystery behind all of this. However, after the 60% mark, in which we solved almost all of the mysteries, the book got less exciting for me. Maybe because I was reading along with the Joe Nesbø book that I'm buddy reading with my friends. This seemed like a lesser version of a Joe Nesbø thriller. The mystery was not complex at all. However, that was not the main reason that I was disappointed in this book. The protagonist of the book was very, very unrelatable, and also was really hard to understand the motivation, why he kept putting himself in danger after realizing the seriousness of the situation. Although it was sort of explained at the end of the book, the protagonist also had a very, very large ego and a god complex, which made him very, very unlikable. Because I had read Kurtlar İmparatorluğu, The Empire of the Wolves by this author, and really, really liked that book, this was a very big disappointment for me. And I gave Leyleklerin Uçuşu by Jean Christophe Grange a 6 out of 10. Today is the 9th of September, and I finished the e-arc that I was reading for Shorty September. I received this e-arc from Book Sirens, and the name of this short thriller was Remember My Lies. Thore Alverson one day goes to his weekend cabin with his wife that he has been married for 1 year. He's very happily married and loves his wife immensely. After returning from a jog, he finds that his wife has disappeared, and there are blood all over place. And all the details following the subsequent police investigation point out that Thore has killed his wife. However, Thore has no remembrance of killing his wife or what happened between the time he went for a jog and then came back to his home. I like this thriller much more than I thought I would. It was quite interesting. The writing was clear. And also very, very engaging. It was such a page-turner for me. Story being full of twists and turns made me want to continue and be curious about what really happened. Although I kind of guessed the big twist, I had no idea about the motive, which seemed to be much more complex than I originally thought it was. So this was quite an enjoyable read for me. I learned from the site that Drea Summers previously wrote in German, and this was her first novel that she wrote in English. And if she continues to write her novels in English, I will read more from this author because I really like the way that she constructed the mystery in her domestic thriller. So I gave Remember My Lies by Drea Summer an 8 out of 10. Today is the 14th of September, and I finished two books actually 2 days ago, but because I was away on a work trip abroad, I can record the video just now. The first book that I finished was the book that I was buddy reading with Nikki at Red Dot Reads and Naomi at Naomi's Bookshelf, which was the 12th book in Harry Hall series, titled Bıçak, Knife by Joe Nesbø. In this book, we follow Harry about a year after the events of the last book. And at the beginning of the book, Harry is devastated because he is separated from his wife, and he is unfortunately back to his old habits. At the morning of a very drunken night, he receives the news of a murder that devastates him, and he tries to find the murderer by going through each suspect. However, as he and his associate at the police department investigate, he finds out that suspects have all alibis. And the investigation takes a very interesting turn when Harry remembers some details from his very drunken night. I really enjoyed this book in the series much more than my body readers. I really did love the mystery, how it was constructed. I was very very shocked by the twist in the end. Unlike the last two previous books, I never even suspected the real killer. Also really like how the previous books affected this book so much. And I'm really loving this complexity both within the book and also within the series. Mystery wise, I think this was at the same level as The Snowman, which is my favorite book so far in the series. However, I can really understand the annoyance of my body readers. I'm really beginning to despise some of the female characters and their very low morals. Maybe this was finally the book got me hooked in the story for the first time in 2 months. I gave Bıçak Knife by Jo Nesbo a 9 out of 10. The second book that I finished 2 days ago was a translated book that I've read in Turkish. Sıfır Noktasındaki Kadın by Nevar El Sadavi. This book was translated to English as Woman at Point Zero. In this book, woman tutor at the university one day goes to prison to help the prisoners. And there she meets a woman who is very very ignorant to all of her work. She becomes really really interested in that woman and her story. Firdevs decides to talk about her life to the narrator. She has been neglected, abused, both physically and sexually by men all her life. At the time when she took control of her life, even as a prostitute, how she was the happiest. She concludes her story with the event that led to her conviction of that. The story was very very sad to read. However, I thought it was very very well written, and I found the concept of being independent and taking control of her life when she was a prostitute very very interesting actually. And I never thought it would make so much sense when a woman has no other options. This book actually gave me a new perspective on this matter. Although I think not all men are so horrible, I can't really understand why Firdevs feels so much hatred towards men. Overall, it was quite a decent story of Egypt in 1970s. I gave Sıfır Noktasındaki Kadın by Neval El Sadavi a 7 out of 10. Today is the 15th of September, and I finished another book for Shorty September, which was called Baba Evi. This novella is the first work in a series of 4 books in which chronicles a man's life from his childhood until the years he is settled. I have previously read the third book in the series, and they all can be read independently. In this novella, Baba Evi, we follow the life of an unnamed narrator from his first memories until the end of his teenage years. And through the eyes of this child and then teenager, we follow the life of the family. At first, the family is quite wealthy and also very well respected in the society. After, the father becomes a member of the opposition party, which goes to extremes to assassinate the Turkish president. He then becomes exiled and has to flee to Lebanon. In Lebanon, the family suffers poverty. This economical situation affects the boy and his siblings very, very much. Throughout the book, we see the physical and verbal abuse of the father. All the time to the children and how this affect the psychology of our narrator so much. I will do a more detailed Turkish shelf video about this book. Overall, I loved the writing style very, very much. The sentences were indeed beautiful, but also very easy to follow. I read the book in quite a short time, and I was really impressed by the author's ability to show very, very political events through the eyes of the child. Also showing how the narrator was affected by the father's abuse. And of course, he did not have an idea how fragile his psychological condition was. It was a very impressive work of literature, and I will certainly read more from Orhan Kemal in the future. He has lots of works that are waiting for me to read. I gave Baba Evi by Orhan Kemal an 8 out of 10. So those were the 6 works that I finished in the first half of September. Please comment down below if you have read any of the books that I mentioned in this video. And if you're a new viewer, first of all, welcome. Please like and subscribe. Hope to see you very soon. Bye! As for Turkish word of the day, I'm going to choose zero. Zero means sıfır in Turkish, and sıfır is our Turkish word of the day. Have a good day!